Hi, and welcome to another episode of The Wide World of Wildlife. I'm your host, Jim Fisher. We're again, once again, in the Carolina swamps. Once again, I still haven't found a regular job, so I'm doing this as a documentary film to educate people on wildlife. I don't expect anybody else to do anything like this. This is kind of the places where I'm walking at and exploring. I've been doing this for over 23-something years. So I've handled all sorts of reptiles and studied herpetology, as well as got a degree in forestry, and been studying biology as well. But anyhow, I'm a naturalist. I believe that when you go into the woods, you should observe nature, really appreciate the little things that God has created, because you can see so much of His wonderful qualities and the things that He has made for us. So we really should take time out, as they say, to smell the roses. So at this time, we're just going to keep looking around, walking around, and seeing what we can find, and seeing what we can explore, and try to be safe. And like I said, don't anybody try this on their own, not unless they're a professional. And I hope you enjoy this. This is going to be fun for me. And I'm going to go ahead and put my helmet cam on, because I'm not like all these other people on Animal Planet and National Geographic. I just have a little digital camera that I tape to my helmet and do these things. My hair is probably all a mess, which the whole world can see. So anyhow, enjoy the wide world of wildlife with Jim Fisher, and let's see what we can find here now. And we're just going to put my helmet cam back on. And we're looking over this way. In fact, I've already spotted something. Looks like a Agkistrodon piscivorus, which is a cottonmouth. And he's right there, as you can see. The cottonmouth is a whole lot more venomous than the copperhead, or some people call them a highland moccasin. Some of them, people call them a pilot snake. The cottonmouth is generally killed by a lot of fishermen and hunters, but they do the ecology real good as far as taking care of rodents and other insects that you don't want at your house. We're in his environment. Even though he is highly venomous, if he was to bite me, I would lose whatever part of the limb that he bit. He's a pit viper. He actually will sometimes stand his ground. Water is a little cold, but he's not wanting to stand his ground right now. And we're going to see, watch him rattle his tail a little bit there. See how he rattled his tail? Kind of mimicking a rattlesnake, trying to make himself look a little bit more venomous than what he is, or a little bit more dangerous. And rattlesnakes are more dangerous. He's a nice size. He's gonna try and scoot his head on back and try and not get bit here. I've been doing this for, like I said, 23 years, and never been bit. And don't plan on getting even bit today. Real nice specimen, as you can see. I wish I had something besides my keys. Nice sized body. And you know what? He is really beautiful. Beautiful snake. He's got that triangular head. It's a nice shaped body. He's got that awful odor that they'll excrete to get away from their prey. Of course, he's trying to, he's biting himself. Poor thing, just looks like he's lost a fang when he did that, but I'm not gonna let him bite me. trying to fling this. I'm gonna have to wash my hands. It looks like poor thing. Try not to hurt him. Looks like he's fling some of his poison on me, on my hands. Whew. And when he did that, let's see if we got a stick here. Let's see if we can see what he's got going on here. See the cotton in his mouth. Oh, mercy. He's got a little bit of fang left there. And those fangs grow back. He's lost that one there, but there's one in there. And they are highly, highly venomous. They can inject you, put you in the hospital, and kill you. Even though not too many people I know, I haven't really, really heard anybody getting bit by water moccasin and dying in years. See him bunched down on that right there? That stick, boy, he's shooting venom in that stick. And he's not wanting to let go. See, that stick got a hole in it. I don't know if you can see that hole or not. But he is a get-goer there. Ain't you, mate? And let's see. You see the nostril. There's the pits. There. And they're heat-seeking. They release a hemotoxin. I'm going to let him go. Let him be on his way. So we won't bother with him anymore. And so here we are, me and my friend here. Let's see. I don't know what to call him because I don't know if it's a male or female. Let's see. Let's see if it's a male or a female. I'm not going to like this. It's going to go all the way down to the anal plate. And I'm holding out the nickel really good. There's the anal plate. And I don't feel no male. They actually, he's got something in here. She does. They actually give to live births. They don't lay eggs. So that's something interesting about these snakes. Some snakes actually lay eggs. These actually give to live birth. So nice specimen. It's a good size. Nice size cottonmouth. Very deadly. Don't ever do what I'm doing right now. My mom gonna kill me when she sees this. She always does. But anyhow, like I said, I've been doing this for 23 years. Never been bit by a poisonous or a non-poisonous snake, because my daddy always says, you know, the end of the gun, you know, the end of the gun that you don't want pointed at you, it's the one where the bullet comes out. Well, that's where the bullet comes out. So that's the end we don't want to touch us, as far as that's concerned. So as long as you can remember that and stay away from them if they come in your yard, I can understand people taking care of them when they come in their yard, because that's your territory, but this is his environment, or her environment. I'm sorry, sweetie. And we are going to let you go. Yes, we are. We're going to let you go right there. Okay. All right. And then she's in the water. She's trying to bite my foot.